We'll go for like 3 logo variations.
We have it. We've got our first client on board.
Oh. Welcome to day 2 of the new series where I show you exactly how I'm building my new design agency behind the scenes so you can make some motherfucking money.
Good morning. It's currently 2 p.m. It's not quite the morning. I've just posted the very first video on YouTube and on Instagram, so I've spent the entire morning editing that video. So we're starting things a little bit later. But good news, after last night's messages to old leads and also some influencers that I'd be interested in working with for free, we've managed to get 2 replies. One of them booked a call for 6 p.m. for some free work, and the other one is for midnight tomorrow, which is 8 p.m. UK time, and that could potentially be our first client. So the new client was an old potential client of mine that we just couldn't agree on a budget. So I contacted them, offered them a massive reduced discount to work on the brand identity because I think it'd be a great first project without having to do a passion project. Works for both parties. They get a discounted brand identity and we start to build our portfolio with influencers who want to release brands. So hopefully that goes well. We need to send them over some strategy questions this morning for them to look over. I've also agreed as well that we can film the entire thing, including all of the calls. That was included in the discounted price. So amazing start. I couldn't have asked for a better start. So hopefully that all goes well. So today we need to send that over, send them questions over, and then we also need to create this newsletter sequence. Now, I don't think I'm going to do a video newsletter sequence anymore, just because it's going to take up too much time and we don't know how well it's going to convert in the first place. So I'd rather do a normal newsletter sequence first, see how that performs, and then if that performs well, we'll upgrade it into a video newsletter sequence in the future. So we've got a busy day. We're going to also visit Dubai Mall today. I'm going to also think of a few other things to do while I'm here. But first of all, we need to plan this newsletter sequence and get these questions sent out to Jude. We're going to have a look at some examples of newsletter sequences, and I know that someone who I was watching a while back called Dickie Bush is like the top dog in the newsletter scene. So a good way to find out how somebody creates their newsletters without even paying for a subscription or a course to learn about them is by simply signing up to their newsletter. So we're going to sign up to his newsletter now and check out the 5 emails that it initially sends you. And to be honest, I think I've already done it in the past, so I'm going to just quickly search in here. I've got a folder on my emails, which is newsletter ideas. And yeah, so I've got the first 5 ideas here, which he's done. And we can start to put a bit of a twist on it. So his first email example is, are you ready to 10x your views, audience growth, and content output? And as you can see, the sort of stuff that he's writing in here, we can pretty much take and put our own twist on it. Just finished creating the subject headings, and these are the 7 that I've decided to go for. We've got an introduction one, ready to 10x your revenue and brand impacts as an influencer, and we've got our outro call to action, which is ready to build a 6-figure influencer brand. Here's how we'll do it together. Now I might increase that to 7, but I think for now we're going to keep that as 6-figure, and then in between just a 5-day course which is going to guide influencers on how they can actually monetize their audience. Now I'm going to spend the next hour, I think maximum, which will take us to 4 o'clock, fulfilling all of these headings and creating the body copy for them. And yeah, after that we're going to head to the mall and send Jude, who could be our first client, the first initial questionnaire to complete so we can start to understand his brand, in line for our call on Friday. And then at 6 p.m. today, which is in 3 hours from now, we have our first call for some free portfolio building work with Connor. Okay, that was an interesting hour. That's a lot of writing later. We finally finished our 5 email course. And to be honest, it's a really, really strong script for each one. Now I'm going to just create this in text format. I'm not actually going to act this out on video. However, over the next few weeks, we'll see how this is actually performing, if we've actually converted any clients from it. And if so, I'll probably create it into a video course rather than a text course, because I feel like they are more effective. However, they take a lot longer to record. Now, the whole point of having this newsletter sequence is to get them to the final email, which is ultimately giving them a one-time 20% discount if they book a call within the next 3 days. Now, this obviously encourages them to move fast. And if they've read everything, then they're probably going to be motivated more than ever to actually get started with the brand. So this is why it's really effective. I'm going to put this together later on Beehive. I'll show you how it's done.
But for now, I need to send over them questions to Jude.
So I'm just going to send this over and see if Jude would like to fill this out before the call. If so, it just gives me a better understanding of his preferences, and I can put together a bit more of an accurate representation of the direction of the brand that we're going to go for when creating this brand, which will help me sell it.
So an update of where we're up to. We've done the newsletter sequence. We've got 5 email day course with an email that goes out before and after the course. And on top of that, I've also invited Jude now to his Notion portal. So he's got some client questionnaires to complete. And when he fills out them, I'm going to jump on back on camera and show you exactly what he's put. And then we can start to put together a little bit of a strategy. So it just helps me in actually selling the brand identity services to him, as I can tailor the direction of the brand more to what he's actually after, rather than just giving him generic examples from different different brand identities.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Amazing. How have you been?
Good, buddy. Yeah, just been golfing, and I've still got the full-time job, so that's keeping me pretty busy.
Good stuff. Now, how's the page going?
It's going well. It's grown. Since we last chatted, it's probably grown maybe 8,000 followers. I'm trying to get that number to 50,000 by being in Canada. Like, the goal should be to try and shift the brand to YouTube, and so stuck in the TikTok and Instagram.
Yeah, it's tough. It's tough to make that shift. First, you try and spend way too long editing these videos and putting them together, when really it's just a game of volume.
When I started to post like 3 times a day on the TikTok and Insta, and they weren't great videos, it was almost like the algorithm like picked me up, and that's how I was able to grow.
The more you post, it only takes that one to blow, and then from there people are committed to watching all your videos then, aren't they? So is it still the personal brand to the T that we'll be working on here?
Yeah, we're trying to make it, take a next step into more of like a golf brand, where, you know, we can create merch, or we can create just more of like it's a golf brand to me, but we haven't taken that next step yet. Right now, it's just kind of like posting the short form content, sort of getting the name out there, but I want to take that next step and make it an actual brand.
We'll go for like 3 logo variations, color selection to match that, typography pairing as well, if that sounds good to you.
Yep, so if you look at the brand strategy section there, there's a client questionnaire. That is pretty much all I need you to fill out today.
Cool, we'll chat tomorrow or Saturday, whatever.
Amazing, cool, thank you for your time.
See you, buddy.
Take care, Connor. See you later. So there we have it. We've got our first client on board. It's a free client, Portfolio Workings. That's Connor, who I met previously last year. He's been working on his golf brand, and I'm looking forward to working on this project. It means that we can finally get hands-on and start designing rather than just talking about designing. And yeah, tomorrow we're going to start with the mood boarding section. So I'm going to show you exactly how I mood board, what websites that I use for inspiration, and how I present it to clients as well. So we'll catch up tomorrow. I'll show you exactly how it's done. But first, we're gonna go to Dubai Mall, and we're going to, first of all, check it out, and then we still need to do the Beehive newsletters. So we've scripted them now. We just need to put them into a working format where people can subscribe and receive the course. Check it. To work on the Beehive newsletter. I've just had a walk around Dubai Mall. Lovely place. There's a lot to do here, a lot more than you'd think. I've only ever been to malls in the UK, but absolutely nothing like this. We've even got an aquarium in here, so there's lots to do. But more importantly, we need to get this newsletter sorted by the end of the tonight, and then the website's pretty much complete. All we need to do then is create a case study, which we've already prepped up. I'm hoping they've got Wi-Fi here. If not, I'm a little bit screwed. All right, let's try. Oh, here we go. Dubai Mall Wi-Fi. Perfect. Oh, I swear to God, I'm the clumsiest person ever. I just smashed a pot off the edge of the table in front of everybody, but these things happen. Wow, that's a good latte. Right, let's jump into this. So I'm going to use Beehive just because I'm familiar with it and I think that it's a really good tool to build a to build your newsletters on. We're going to create a new account because obviously we have zero email list. And this is essentially going to be an automation when people first sign up to the newsletter. We're going to put in brackets 5-day course because that is essentially what it is. Oh, perfect. Thank you very much. Thank you. That's what we've ordered. Get a bit of food in me for the past 2 days. I've been on omelettes from the hotel, so I'm looking forward to this nice meal. But yes, we need to create this trigger, and the trigger is going to be when people sign up to the newsletter. So we've got signed up here, and then can add another trigger if an email submitted as well, and we'll save that. And now we're going to click send email, drag that into there, and before we've got the list of our emails that we've created. So our first one is ready to 10x your revenue and brand impact as an influencer, and we've got the entire copy there. Might need to tweak certain bits here and there. So I'm just going to repeat this for the 5 emails, and then by the end of it, we send the 20% one-time discount that they can't get anywhere else, which will encourage people to take action immediately. We're just going to make our final tweaks now. We need to go to the page that it's on the Influencer Branding Agency website, which was our case studies. And we're just going to change this coming soon to sign up. I'm going to put a link on there as well. Link in, free 5-day course. There we go, publish, and we're all done. Last thing on the website to do is literally this case study, and then the website is fully polished. And that, folks, is all she wrote. Unfortunately, that's the end of today's episode. It's a little bit shorter than yesterday, but we got through a lot. Tomorrow we've got an unexpected big day. We've got a client call which could potentially be our very first client. But more importantly, we've got to mood board Connor's new brand to the T. And I think we're going to be doing that by the beach. Now, what better way to connect with nature than go to the beach and find some pure inspiration? Am I making excuses to go to the beach? Most likely. If you've got any recommendations at all whilst I'm in Dubai, drop them in the comments below, send me a DM. Also, send me a DM if you've got any questions at all. I'm going to be answering everybody's questions. This series is for you, not for me. So see you tomorrow.